好的，我们开始。
Om Gyanatmarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namah Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shrimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So this evening we're on chapter 23 of the fifth canto Srimad Bhagavatam. Sukadeva Goswami is going to describe the Sishumara planetary system.
今天晚上我们要学习的是圣典薄伽瓦坛第五篇的第23章。圣苏卡德瓦戈斯瓦米将会为我们描述西舒马尔星系。
Sishumara is Sanskrit for a dolphin. Dolphin, you know the dolphin that plays in the water? They jump up and down and dive and carry a ball in their nose and they're very playful creatures.
这个西舒马尔它的这个梵文词的意思是一个海豚，这个海豚就是在水里面游的那个非常可爱的那个海豚。
So there's a group of planets, and it's you know the dolphin is imagined, but from the arrangement, from the alignment of the different planets, that their arrangement it appears like they're representing a dolphin.
实际上是这些星系连接在一起来，然后显得好像是一个海豚的这个形状。
Okay, so Sukadeva Goswami is describing, he says that in the last chapter we were hearing about the planets of the seven sages, and now he's describing that above the planets of the seven sages is the abode of Lord Vishnu.
圣苏卡德瓦戈斯瓦米在上一章给我们讲述了这个七个圣贤所住的星球，而这七个圣贤所住的星球之上的这个地方是主威士努居住的地方。
So there's seven great sages who reside up there in the top of the universe. They're very elevated souls. They're all sons of Brahma, and they have they're very powerful.
这七个圣贤所居住的星球在这个宇宙的顶部，然后他们是有一些是主 Brahma 的儿子，他们非常的有力量，而且非常的有力量。
But above them is this the abode of Lord Vishnu, and it's on that planet where Dhruva Maharaj resides.
而在这七个星球之上是主威士努所居住的地方，在这个星球上是 Dhruva Maharaj 所也在那里。
Dhruva Maharaj was given the benediction. Wasn't really a benediction, but remember, Dhruva Maharaj wanted to have a great kingdom, so he was given this planet to reside on.
我们之前知道 Dhruva Maharaj, 他想得到一个益处，就是他想有一个国王，有一个国家，一个王国。最后，他被得到了这个星球作为他居住的地方。
And he was told by the Lord that he would have to stay there until the end of the creation.
主告诉他，朱瓦马哈拉就必须在这个创造的结束之后，一直在这个结束之前，一直得待在那个地方。
That Dhruva Maharaj has to stay there for the whole life of Brahma, until the end of the life of Brahma, when there's annihilation.
也就是说 Dhruva Maharaj 待在那个地方得待着 主 Brahma 过一生的这个时间 Dhruva Maharaj 都在那个地方直到这个毁灭的时候。
And then Agni, the god of fire,And Indra, the god of rain, and Prajapati means the forefather, god of the forefathers, and Kashyapa, who is the father of many living entities, and Dharma, religion, they all assemble there.
Agni, 火神, Indra, 雨神, Prajapati,先祖们卡夏帕也是指生物体的祖先 Dharma 宗教他们都聚集在那里
and they offer honor and obeisances to Dhruva Maharaj
他们都在那里向 Dhruva Maharaj 表示敬意
and with their right side towards Dhruva they will circumambulate him they will go around him
他们以右侧对着他，这样可以环绕着他。
So Dhruva Maharaj is given so much respect by all these great personalities.
Dhruva Maharaj 受到这些非常伟大的人物的尊敬。
Because Dhruva Maharaj had become a pure devotee, so they were honoring him.
因为 Dhruva Maharaj 是一位非常纯粹的奉献者。所以这些人都在荣耀他。
So this planet where Dhruva Maharaj resides, this is the pole star.
Dhruva Maharaj 所居住的这个星球叫做北极星。
And this pole star is always shining, and it's right in the center. It's the center of all the stars and the planets.
北极星总是不停地闪耀着，而且它是这个星球中所有星球的中枢部分。
And all the other planets and the stars, they all rotate around the pole star.
所有其他的这些星系都围绕着这个北极星不停地旋转。
And they rotate, they're continually rotating.Because they're controlled by the time factor, causes them to keep moving. They keep going around the pole star.
他们在时间这个因素的影响下，被迫的不停的旋转。
So the planets and the stars, under the influence of the time factor, they go around the pole star.
由于时间的因素的影响，他们总是围绕着这个北极星不停地旋转。
Time factor is just another feature of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
时间因素的影响也是至尊人格守神的
Krishna
其中的一个影响。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita in the 11th chapter,Kalosmi loka kshaya krit pravito. Krishna says, Time I am, destroyer of the world, and I come to claim all people.
Chu Krishna 在《佛家梵歌》的第十一章讲到，我是时间，毁灭这个世界所有的一切。
Right, Krishna showed that his Kala Rup, his form of time, to Arjuna on the battlefield of Kurukshetra.
主 Krishna 在 Kurukshetra 战场上给 Arjuna 展示了他的时间的形体。
And in that Kala Rup, Arjuna could see all the soldiers, Bhishma and Drona and Karna, everybody was being killed. They were all entering into his form of time. And everybody was going to die except for the Pandavas.
在这个 Kala Rupa 时间的形体下， 阿尔朱娜看到了所有的这些战场上的逼什马等等这些人全都死去了，除了潘德瓦兄弟。
So everyone is under the control of time, except for Krishna.
所有人都在时间因素的影响下，除了 Krishna.
But Krishna loves Dhruva Maharaj so much that he put Dhruva Maharaj in charge of the time factor.
但是至尊人格守神非常深爱 Dhruva Maharaj, 所以他让 Dhruva Maharaj 来控制这些时间因素。
The time factor works under Dhruva Maharaj, and all the planets and all the stars, they're all moving around Dhruva Maharaj on the pole star.
Dhruva Maharaj 控制着时间因素， Dhruva Maharaj 的控制之下，所有的星球它们都围绕着这个北极星旋转。
So we say everything is done by the arrangement of Krishna, but Krishna wants his devotee to do the service.
我们可以看到一切都在至尊人格守神 Krishna 的指令下活动，但是主 Krishna 他希望他的奉献者来担当这个服务。
So Krishna, he makes Dhruva the most important person in the universe.
所以 Krishna 让 Dhruva 成为这个宇宙中最重要的人物。
Because he's controlling the time factor, it's under his control.
因为所有的时间因素的活动都置于他的控制之下。
Sukadeva Goswami now gives an example to describe about how the planets are moving around the pole star.
Sukadeva Goswami 给我们描述了一个例子，讲述所有的这些星球是如何围绕着北极星旋转的。
He said, just like in the countryside, in the farms, they will have bulls, and they will use the bull to crush the rice.
就像在这个压榨这个谷物的时候，中间那个磨旁边也是个轮子，这中间这个磨的这个轮子外面是一个牛，一个公牛在围绕着这个轮子旋转。
Yeah. There are three bulls, one on the inside, one in the middle, one on the outside, and the three bulls they go around that pole in the center.
总共有三头公牛，一头公牛在中间，一头在外面，一头在这个最近的这个里面，他们都围绕着这个中间在转。
And they cannot go any other place. They have to keep just going around that center pivot.
他们不能走到别的地方，他们只能一直不停地围绕着这个中间在旋转。
So similarly in the universe,all the planets and all the stars and there are hundreds and thousands of stars, they all revolve around the pole star.
同样的道理，所有的行星以及成千上万的这些星星都在各自的轨道上围绕着北极星旋转。
And they all have their own individual orbits.
他们都有他们各自的 orbits.
Orbit, yeah, to go around the site, the path which they use to go around the route.
他们都有他们各自的轨道结果。
So the material nature is like a machine, and it acts under the control of the Supreme Lord.
这个物质自然就像一台机器。它是在至尊人格守神的控制下在活动。
So these different planets which are all, and stars which are all going around the pole star, they're driven by the wind. The wind is what gets them to move around. There's a special wind there in the space, and that wind causes these planets to go around the pole star.
所有这些星系围绕着北极星在旋转，而驱动这些星系的这个东西是风，在这个空间的一种特殊的风。
And they keep doing it, they don't stop until the end of the creation.
直到这个创造的结束，他们都会一直保持着这种行移动的状态。
And the planets all float in air, within the, in the space, they're all floating in the air.
所有这些行星都漂浮在空气之中。
Just like you get big clouds, the heavy rain clouds, the rain cloud may carry many, many tons of water in the rain cloud, but still the cloud is floating in the air.
这些行星漂浮在空气中，就好像在空气中我们看到的那些云朵也漂浮在空中。这些云朵虽然储藏了几百吨的很多很多的水在它的这个云朵之中，但是它仍然能漂浮在空气之中。
Or Sukadeva Goswami gives another example. He says there's birds, special birds which are called Shena eagles, and they're huge. They're so big, they can pick up elephants.
Sukadeva Goswami 也给我们描述了另外一个例子，就像一个叫 Shena 的这个鹰，它非常非常的巨大，以至于它甚至可以把一头大象给抓起来。
Yeah, they can pick up the elephant and they can fly up in the sky and then they can drop the elephant to the ground.
它可以把这个大象给抓起来，然后把它拎到空中，然后再把它摔下去。
And when the elephant falls in the ground, if they want, then they can come and eat it.
当这个大象从空中摔下去的时候，这个鹰就再去吃这头大象。
So these eagles, these birds are so big, they're so powerful. They can fly high in the sky, and they don't fall down. They never fall to the ground.
这个鹰非常的巨大，它可以在天空中翱翔，但是很少，基本都不着陆。
So in his description, Sukadeva Goswami is describing how all these planets, they're all moving, each one of them has their own orbit, their own path as they go around the pole star. They don't collide with each other. They don't bump into each other.
Sukadeva Goswami 给我们描述了所有这些行星，这些星系是如何的围绕着北极星在旋转的。他们都有着各自的轨道，而且不被挤，就是不会被纠缠在一起。
The path which the planets move, just like something arranged by a machine. So the material nature is like a machine, which operates for the stars and for the planets.
这些行星，他们都有各自的轨道，就像一台机器，他们都沿各自的轨道运行。
And their movement, their motion is exactly according to the order of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
而他们都是在至尊人格守神的命令下运行。
They do not act independently, but they act under the full control.
他们不会独自的行动，而是全然的在至尊人格守神的命令下。
And each of the planets and stars which are there in the sky, each of them have a presiding deity, and that presiding deity, he will have a chariot, and they travel on their chariot as they go around.
每一个星系，他们都有各自的这个神邸，他们都坐着各自的这个马车在运行。
So all the planets and stars are all personalities, and they're all servants of the Supreme Lord.
所有这些星球的统治神邸都是人，他们都是至尊人格守神的仆人。
Even the sun planet.Is a servant of the Supreme Lord.
即便是太阳神，他也是至尊人格守神的仆人。
The sun is like the eye of the Lord.
太阳就像是至尊人格首领的眼睛。
Right? Without the sun, we cannot see anything. We're dependent on the sun to be able to see.
没有这个太阳，我们无法看见任何的事情。
So, the sun rotates. He has an orbit, and he has a path to go around the pole star. And this is a path of eternal time.
太阳神也有他运行的轨道，而他运行的这个轨道是永恒的时间。
The sun is considered the king of all the planets.
太阳神可以被认为是所有宇宙的这些星系的国王。
And the sun has unlimited potency, unlimited heat and light.
太阳它有无限的热，无限的光。
So even the sun planet is under the control of the Supreme Lord.
即便是太阳神，太阳星系也是在至尊主的控制之下。
Materialistic scientists, they talk about, oh, it's all due to gravity. But we don't agree. We say it's all due to Krishna.
这些物质主义的科学家认为所有的这一切都是源于万有引力，但是我们不同意这种看法。我们相信这一切都是源自于 Krishna.
Material scientists, they don't like to accept that there's a supreme government ruling these different planets, and that government is ruled by Krishna.
物质主义科学家他们不希望不承认有至尊人格守神所统治的这些星球的政府，他们不相信有 Krishna.
So materialist scientists, they're thinking everything is just moving by chance and there's no person there, but we don't agree.
所以这些物质主义科学家认为一切都只是偶然的在行动，没有人，但是我们并不同意这一看法。
We say there's a Supreme Lord, and then there's all the deities of the different planets. They're all persons, and the Supreme Lord is also a person.
我们认为有一位至尊主，他是一位人，而所有的星球上他们也有的控制的这个人。
So the Supreme Lord, he orders all these demigods, all these stars and planets. The personalities in charge of these different stars and planets, he orders them what to do and how to move.
因此，至尊主他控制着所有的这些星系，所有星系上的这些人，这些控制者，他控制着让他们是如何在行动的。
And Krishna confirms this in the Bhagavad Gita.
这一点在博迦梵歌的中 Krishna 证明了。
Krishna says, this material nature is moving under my direction, O son of Kunti.
主 Krishna 说，昆提之子啊，这个物质自然是在我的指挥之下，我的指挥之下运作。
And it is producing all moving and non-moving beings.
它产生所有动和不动的一切。
So, by this rule,The manifestation is created and annihilated again and again. Material nature, there's creation, there's annihilation, again and again. It's all under Krishna's direction.
所有的一切都是在 Krishna 的指挥之下，在这个规律之下，物质自然展示再三的创造，再三的毁灭。
So the path on which the planets move around the pole star, they're like the bodies of different living entities.
这些行星的轨道好像众生做，就像我们的这些躯体一样。
Just like some machine which is controlled by Krishna.
它也像由至尊主 Krishna 所控制的一台机器。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna speaks about this. He says, he's in the heart of all living entities and he directs them.
Krishna 在主 Krishna 在波迦梵歌中说，他住在每一个人的心里，指导着众生行动。
And we're all seated on a machine made of the material energy.
而我们就坐在一台由物质能量组成的机器之上。
So this machine of material nature, this is the Kala Chakra. This is the form of time.
我们坐的这个物质自然的这个机器，可以被称为是 Kala Chakra， 物质时间的这种机器。
The Supreme Lord and the material nature work together.
物质自然和至尊主合作着。
Not only just this one universe, but all the universes which are here in the material creation, and there's an infinite number.
不仅仅是这个宇宙，它维持着所有的整个的宇宙。
So Sukadeva Goswami is describing how these planets and stars, how they are able to float in space.
Sukadeva Goswami 也给我们描述了这些星球是如何漂浮着。
And it's not due to the law of gravity.
它不是由于引力的定律。
It's due to the air which is, they float in the special air which is there.
是因为有一种特殊的空气。
And Sukadeva Goswami gave the example about the big cloud. The big cloud can carry so much water, but it can float in the sky.
Sukadeva Goswami 也给我们描述了，举了一个例子，就好像在空中有一个巨大的云，它虽然带着很多的雨水，但是仍然可以漂浮在空中。
And we see also big airplanes.Big airplanes, jet airplanes, they go up in the air and they can float up there, they can carry so many people, they float in the sky. So, this is the cooperation between the material nature and Krishna. Krishna is the Purush, and the material nature is the Prakriti.
主 Krishna 是 Purush, 而物质自然是 Prakriti.
Right, Prakriti is feminine, and Purusha is male.
Prakriti 是阴性的能量，而至尊主它是阳性的、雄性的。
So.The personification of the material nature is Mother Durga.
物质自然的代理人是 Durga 母亲。
Mother Durga is, people often worship her in the material world.
人们都非常崇拜这个物质自然，崇拜 Durga 女神。
But Mother Durga, she is also under the control of the Supreme Lord, Govinda. The material nature is not independent. So the word Durga means like a fort or like a house which is not easy to get out of.
Durga 的这个意思还有堡垒的意思，就是说这个堡垒很难以突破。
So this material universe is like that. Mother Durga, she's like protects this fort, this big house which she can't get out. She makes sure we stay here.
Durga 女神因此就做了这样的事情，她保护这个，她让这个物质世界的所有的我们都很难以出去。
So all of us conditioned souls, we get kept here until we are able to become liberated.
我们所有这些受条件限制的灵魂都被关在这儿，直到我们得到解脱才行。
If we want to get liberated, we need to get the mercy of the Supreme Lord.
而我们要得到解脱，就必须得到至尊主的仁慈才行。
And we get the mercy of the Supreme Lord when we become Krishna conscious, when we understand Krishna's birth and activities.
而要得到至尊主的仁慈，我们得理解至尊主的活动、出生和活动。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, one who knows the nature of my birth and activities, then when they give up this body, they won't come back to this world.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说，人若能了解我显现和活动的超然本质，离开躯体后再也不会回来。
And the different persons who are in charge of these different stars and planets, they are all very pious living entities.
不同的这些星球上的主宰的这些神，他们都是非常虔诚的灵魂。
Just like the moon, there's a personality in charge of the moon. His name is Jiva. He's a person.
就像月亮上的这个掌管者。他被称为基瓦，他也是一位人，一位生物。
All the different demigods, they get their position because of their pious activities.
所有这些半世人能得到这样的位置，都是因为他们前生的虔诚活动。
Only the sun is not a living entity. The deity of the sun is an incarnation of the Supreme Lord.
只有太阳神的这个主宰神。它不是一个个体生物，它是至尊人格首神的化身。
It's called Surya Narayan.
它被称为 Surya Narayan.
Dhruva, of course, in charge of Dhruva Loka, he's a living entity. He's like us.
Dhruva Maharaj, 他也是一位生物，跟我们一样，也是一位生物。
So there's the Supreme Lord and there's the living entities.
有两类生物，至尊生物和我们这些普通的生物。
And we are all the servants of the Supreme Lord.
我们都是主的仆人。
So big birds, the Vedas tell us about these big birds, big eagles, which are so big, they can fly from one planet to another.
我们在这些诗中还听到有一个巨大的鹰，巨大的鸟。这个鸟它可以从一个星球飞到另外一个星球。
And when they're in the flight, when they're flying from one planet to another, sometimes they will lay eggs, and the eggs hatch.
当他们从一个星球飞到另外一个星球的时候，他们在飞行的过程中还会下蛋。
And the eggs hatch, and the birds come out from the egg. Another bird comes out from the eggs.
这个蛋在空气就在下坠的这个过程中，马上就会孵化成另外的一只鸟。
I was in the Philippines some years ago, and I saw we went to visit a zoo there.And they had one bird there. It was just huge. It was a huge bird.
几年前我在菲律宾的时候，我住在那里，我看到一，我看我们去拜访一个地方，那个地方看到一个巨大的鸟。
And it saw me and my friend, and it got angry. It wanted to come and attack us. Fortunately, it was in a big cage.
当时这个鸟非常的生气，它甚至想来攻击我们。幸好我们当时在一个山洞里面。
I'd never seen such a bird before. It was so huge.
我从来没有见到过这么大的一只巨鸟。
So here we're hearing about these things that there are such birds. Just like sometimes we see eagles, they will take a monkey, they will pick up a monkey and they will throw him down and.Kill him and eat it. So there are birds which can pick up elephants.
比如说我们也听到过有一些鹰它可以捕捉猴子，把它们拎到空中，然后摔死它们，然后吃掉它们。在这里我们也听到有这样的一个大鸟大鹰，它可以把大象给抓起来。
So two examples, the cloud carrying all the water floating in space and the big eagle.
因此这里有两个类比的例子，第一个是空气中携带着这些雨水的云朵，还有一个就是这个大鸟。
How do they do it? How is it? It's possible by the air.
他们是如何能做到这一点的呢？是因为他们通过调整空气。
In the same way, the planets are floating in the air, according to the order of the Supreme Lord.
同样，这些星球，它们也在空中得以漂浮，也是在至尊主，也是调整空气，也是在至尊主的命令之下调整着空气，使其漂浮着。
People may say, "Well, that's the law of gravity." So we say yes, but it's Krishna's law. It's not just some science. It's nothing which science had anything to do with. It's the arrangement of the Supreme Lord Krishna.
人们也许会说这是万有引力定律，但是呢，这种引力定律也是至尊主的定律，也是至尊主的法律。它是在至尊主的控制之下，它不是由一个人创造的，它是至尊人格守神本人创造的。
So this machine of stars and planets, it's like it has the form of the dolphin, the Sishumara.
因此，这些星球的这些星球构成了一个西舒马尔的一个海豚的形象。
And sometimes this form of the Sishumara is considered an incarnation of Krishna, Vasudev.
有时他也被认为是主 Krishna Vasudeva 的化身。
And sometimes yogis will meditate upon this form because it's something they can actually see. They can see these stars, they can see these planets, they can meditate on this.
有一些瑜伽师会冥想这种 Vasudeva 的这个形象，因为他可以看见这个形象。
Because some people, they're not able to accept the form of Krishna as a person. So they like to think about big stars, they like to think about the form, the universal form.
因为一些瑜伽师他不愿意接受至尊主的人体的这个形象，他宁愿去接受至尊主的宇宙形象。
And some yogis, they think about this dolphin swimming in the sky, just like the dolphin swims in water.
有一些瑜伽师冥想这个西舒马尔的这个海豚，就好像他冥想着这个海豚在空中游泳，就好像这个海豚在海里游泳一样。
And they meditate upon it as a universal form, as a big form of the Supreme Lord.
他们冥想的是至尊主的宇宙的巨大的这个形体。
So Sukadeva Goswami goes on to describe different parts of the body of the fish and the different places on the around with how the different stars represent different parts of the dolphin.
Sukadeva Goswami 将会为我们描述在这些星球是如何在这一个。海豚的哪些各土各种不同的位置上
？The different planets, they're all parts of this body of the Sishumara.
这些所有的星球都是西舒马尔这个海豚它不同的部分。
So Sukadeva Goswami says that this body of the Sishumara, it's the external form of Vishnu.
Sukadeva Goswami 跟我们说，这个西舒马尔的这个星系是主 Vishnu 的外在的形象。
And morning, midday, and evening, we should observe this form of the Lord. We should meditate on it silently.
在一天之中的早上、正午和傍晚，一个人应当默默地冥想这个西舒玛尔的形象。
And there's a special mantra which they will worship him with this mantra.
而且崇拜这个形象的时候，有一个特殊的曼陀罗。
They will pray to the Lord that you have assumed the form of time.
他们向主祈祷道，您化身为时间的形象。
And all the different planets are moving. You are the resting place of all the planets in their different paths.
在不同轨道上运行的所有星球的栖息所。
And you are the master of all the demigods.
您是所有半世人的主。
You are the supreme person.
您是至尊的人。
So I offer my obeisances to you and meditate upon you.
我要向您致以虔诚的顶拜，并且冥想您。
So this body of the Supreme Lord Vishnu, which is in the form of the dolphin, this is the place of the resting place of all the demigods.
这个形成了西舒玛尔的这个至尊主的威士努的形体，也就是这个海豚的形体，是所有半世人和众行星星球的休息的一个地方。
And all the different stars and planets are all there within that form.
所有的星球都在这个形体之中。
And Sukadeva Goswami gives a benediction. He said, if you chant this mantra to worship the Supreme Lord three times a day, then he will free you from all sinful reactions.
Sukadeva Goswami 描述了这个的益处。如果一天三次，早上、中午、晚上能够唱诵这首曼陀罗，那位至尊就会超越一切的罪恶反应。
And if we offer obeisances to this form, or remember this form three times a day, then all our sinful activities will be destroyed.
如果一个人一天三次的向这个形象记忆顶拜或者记忆这个形象，他所有的罪恶活动都会被摧毁。
So, one of the Acharyas, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, he says that if you're able to meditate on this arrangement of the Vishwarup, the universal form, the form of the Supreme Lord, then... Go ahead.
我们的一位阿差拉圣维什瓦纳查科瓦提塔库尔，概括了这个宇宙形体。他说，如果能够安排冥想这种维拉图鲁帕，或者说这个形体的话
，Right? If you worship him three times a day, meditate on him, then you will always be free from sinful reactions.
如果能一天三次的冥想他，崇拜他。这个人会超越所有的罪恶活动的反应。
So the Dhruva Loka planet, it's very far above the sun.
Dhruva Loka 这个星球，也就是这个北极星，距离太阳非常的远。
But there's planets above Dhruva Loka.
也有星球在朱瓦罗卡之上。
There's special planets. There's first of all Mahar Loka, which is very far above Dhruva Loka.
在朱瓦罗卡之上有一个特别的星球叫 Mahar Loka.
And above Mahar Loka, then there's Jnana Loka.
在 Mahar Loka 之上是 Jnana Loka.
And above Jnana Loka, Tapa Loka.
Jnanaloka 之上是 Tapaloka,
and above Tapaloka, he come to Satyaloka.
他 Tapaloka 之上是 Satyaloka。
Satyaloka means the place where Lord Brahma resides。
Satyaloka 的意思是主 Brahma 所居住的地方。
Right? Tapaloka, you get people like the four Kumaras live there on Tapaloka。
我们在就是 Tapaloka 是四 Kumar 兄弟他们居住的地方。
And Janaloka and Mahaloka, this is where very great sages were fixed in transcendence live.
而 Janaloka 和 Mahaloka 是那些伟大的圣人和伟大的圣人所居住的地方。
So you want, if you want to go to Vaikuntha, you have to go, that's above the Satyaloka.
因此如果你想要去到外昆塔的话你得超越萨提亚罗卡。
It's a long way to go.
这要去到那是很长远的。
But you have to pass all of these things to enter into the spiritual sky.
你得超越所有这一切才能进入到灵性的天空。
Then below the earth, you've got lower planetary systems.
在地球之下有一些低等的星星。
Right, there are 14 different levels within the universe.
总共有十四个不同的星星。
So from the top, Earth is in the middle. It's about the seventh coming from the top.
从上面有，从顶端有七个。
And then below that, you've got seven different planetary systems.
而在这个七个之下又有七个这些低等的星球。
And then below the lower planets, then you've got Sheshanaga. He's laying in the bottom of the universe in the Garbhodak Ocean.
而在低等的星球之上是低等的星球之下是 Sheshanaga 就是 Garbhodakshayi Vishnu 躺在了这个海洋之上。
So next chapter 24 goes on to describe about the subterranean heavenly planets. The next chapter describes about subterranean heavenly planets. It means heavenly planets which are in the bottom half of the universe.
在下面这一个章节将描述的是地下的这些天堂星球，也就是在地球星球之下的这些星球。
The demons like Bali Maharaj, they reside there in the subterranean heavenly planet.
这些星球是恶魔们居住的星球，比如说也有巴利马哈拉吉他们所居住的这些星球，地下的天堂星球。
Yeah, in the upper planets, you've got the heavenly planets where the demigods reside.
之上面，在这之上面的是天堂星球，是这些半神人居住的星球。
And in the lower half of the universe, you've got the heavenly planets where the demons reside.
在下面的七个星球是低等的星球，是这些恶魔们所居住的星球。
Okay, so we're going to hear also about an invisible planet called Rahu.
我们将听到下面的一个隐形的星球，叫做 Rahu 星球。
So Rahu is below the sun.
Rahu 星球在太阳的下面。
It's below the sun and it's below the moon. It's between these two planets and the earth.
它在太阳和月亮的中间。
And sometimes Rahu will cover the sun or the moon, make an eclipse.
有时候 Rahu 星球会挡在太阳的面前。
What is actually the eclipse? The eclipse is caused because Rahu, this planet, comes in front. of either the sun or the moon.
日食的真正的原因是这个 Rahu 星球挡在了太阳的面前。
And the sometimes there will be a full eclipse, the whole sun will be covered or the whole moon will be covered, and sometimes it will just cover part of the sun or part of the moon.
有些时候这个 Rahu 它是完全的挡住月亮或者太阳，造成日食或月食，有些时候它只挡住一部分。
Of course, during this time, this is considered inauspicious time.
但在这个期间都被认为是不吉祥的时间。
Because Rahu is a demonic planet.
因为 Rahu 是一个恶魔的星球。
So when the demonic planet comes in front of the moon or the moon and the sun, they are heavenly planets, they are higher planets, they are very pious living entities, they are great personalities.And Rahu is demonic, so when the demon comes in front of the good person, in front of the sun or the moon, it's considered offense.
因为 Rahu 是低等的星球，而太阳和月亮他们都属于高等的星球，他们也是比较虔诚的星球。当这个恶魔的星球来到这些高等的星球面前的时候，对这些伟大的人物来说是一种冒犯。
So when a great personality is being offended by another lower person, we don't want to be present there, we don't want to witness, we don't want to see it. So we should never look at the eclipse.
当一位伟大的人物被一个低等的人物所遮挡的时候，当出现这种冒犯的时候，我们不应该在当场去观看这种行为。所以我们不去看日食和月食，我们应该离开这个现场。
We know Lord Chaitanya was born when there was an eclipse.
主 Chaitanya 诞生的时候也是有日食、月食。
And everybody was went, well, they all went to the Ganga to take bath, to purify themselves, and to chant the holy name.
所有的人都跑到恒河那里去沐浴，净化自己，唱诵圣名。
And we read about Lord Krishna coming to Kurukshetra when there was an eclipse.
我们也读到，当这个主 Krishna 来到 Kurukshetra 战场上的时候，也发生过日食。
Yeah. Krishna came to perform sacrifice and to give charity to the brahmanas because it's considered.That will help to counteract the inauspiciousness of the eclipse.
主 Krishna 在祭祀场上做火祭，然后给予这些婆罗门、这些祭司来抵消这种日食的这种不吉祥因素的影响。
So Rahu moves like a star. It's like one of the stars.
Rahu.的星也是一个星球
，and the deity of this planet Rahu is the son of a person called Simhika.
而这个 Rahu 他的这个主宰神体是 Himdika 的儿子。
And he's the most terrible, the most disgusting of all the demons.
这个黑。Himdika 是最令人厌恶的一个恶魔。
But somehow he got the position of being a deity of a planet.
但由于某种原因，他得到担任这个星球的主宰的这个职位。
And he got that position by the grace of the Supreme Personality of God.
他是凭借至尊人格守神的仁慈而获得的那个职位。
What happened was they were drinking nectar, right? But they were Mohini was distributing the nectar.
当时Mohini 在派发这个甘露，在派发甘露的时候，由于某种情况，由于特殊的情况，他喝了那个甘露。
So Mohini was giving the nectar to the demigods, but the demon Rahu sat there with all the demigods.
摩黑尼当时只是想把甘露派给半神人，但是拉虎藏在了这个里面。
And so when they saw, then they cut off the head. They cut off the head. They cut off Rahu's head, but he'd already drank some nectar. So that his head stayed alive, but the rest of the body died.
当他喝下甘露的那一刻，虽然这个虽然摩黑尼已经杀掉了这个拉虎，他的躯体已经死亡了，但是他的头部还喝了甘露。
嗯。So Rahu, he always tries to make trouble between the sun and the moon.
这个 Rahu 总是在太阳和月亮之间造成一些麻烦。
He tries to get between them, and he tries to create conflicts between them.
他总是插入太阳和月亮之间，总是让他们不和。
He's always against both of them. He's against both the sun and the moon.
他又挑起太阳，又挑起月亮，就是总是反对他们，充满敌意。
And he will try to cover the sunshine. He will try to cover the moonshine.
他试图遮蔽阳光和月光。
So he's a big demon.
他是一个大恶魔。
嗯。嗯。Rahu is actually twice as large as the moon.
Rahu 比月亮要大两倍。
And the moon is twice as large as the sun.
月亮比太阳要大两倍。
This is described here.
在这里描述了。
Okay. Okay, well, maybe we'll stop here and ask if there's any questions.
Not yet. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj, 请问是什么力量在阻止我们皈依 Krishna? Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru Maharaj, I want to ask, which power stop us surrender to the Krishna?
Which what?
Which power stop us surrender to the Krishna?
We stop ourselves from surrendering to Krishna. We have independence. Either to surrender to Krishna or to surrender to Maya. This is our independence.
这是我们的独立性。
If we want to become really independent, we have to become dependent on Krishna. That is real independence.
如果我们真的想独立的话，我们得依靠 Krishna, 而依靠 Krishna 是真正的独立。
But because we're all rebellious, we're rebels,We don't like to surrender.
但是我们都不太想皈依 Krishna.
We're thinking, I don't need Krishna. I can enjoy on my own, independently.
我们认为我们不需要 Krishna. 我们可以自己去享受。我们可以不要 Krishna, 自己去独自享受。
We don't realize that we're being controlled. We're always controlled.Either you're controlled by Maya or you're controlled by Krishna.
我们不了解，我们总是处于控制之下。我们要么就被 Krishna 控制，要么就被 Maya 所控制。
So devotees should be intelligent, want to surrender to Krishna.
因此奉献者应该有智慧，我们应该臣服 Krishna。
One who surrenders to Krishna, they're under the protection of Krishna's divine energy.
如果一个人臣服 Krishna 的话，他是在至尊主 Krishna 的神圣的能量的保护之下。
But if we surrender to Durga, we heard about Durga, she has a fort. She has a fort to keep us a prisoner, place which is very difficult to get out of. The material world is like a fort.
但是如果我们臣服物质能量，臣服 Durga 的话，我们听到 Durga 它有一个堡垒，而这个堡垒让我们很难以超越，很难以离开这个物质自然。
So we're stopping ourselves from surrendering to Krishna.
因此我们自己阻止了自己去臣服 Krishna.
Krishna came to speak the Bhagavad Gita to all of us, telling us to surrender to him.
主 Krishna 以薄伽梵歌的形式来到我们面前，告诉我们所有人，请向他臣服。
Krishna is telling us,You have to surrender, take shelter of me. But we're thinking, oh no, I'll be okay, I'm fine, I can do better, I don't need Krishna.
Krishna 说，请臣服我。但是呢，我们这些人会认为，哦，我自己一个人是可以的，我可以自己一个人做，我可以不要 Krishna, 自己可以去做。
So we cannot blame anybody. It's our own fault, our own choosing.
我们不能责怪任何人，只是我们自己的选择，自己的错误。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, he said, I'm not responsible for a person's sinful activities. We chose to do these sinful things ourselves.
Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说，我不会为任何人的罪恶而承担责任，是我们自己要去做这些事情，我们自己要承担这个责任。Next.
Yes.
Next from Harivamsa Prabhu. Guru, 怎么理解太阳神也是至尊人格神手？有些地方的人也在崇拜太阳神。那也算是崇拜至尊人格守神吗？Guru Mahari, I want to know how to understand the Surya is also the Supreme Lord Godhead. Some place, some people also worship the Sun God. So are they also worship the Supreme Lord?
Well, he's the expansion of the Supreme Lord. He's Surya Narayan, right? He's one of the expansions of the Lord.
太阳神是至尊人格守神的一个扩展，它被称为 Surya Narayan.
Just like some people, they meditate on the Super Soul, and they meditate on the Lord in the heart. It's the Super Soul, Paramatma.It's also the Lord, but it's not the Swayam Bhagavan, Sri Krishna, it's not the original Supreme Personality of Godhead, but it's one of his expansions.
就像有一些人他崇拜超灵，崇拜这个 Paramatma, 他们虽然也是在崇拜主，但是他们不是崇拜的这 Swayam Bhagavan,就是崇拜的至尊人格守神，他们不是崇拜的主 Krishna 本人，他们只是崇拜的这个超灵而已。
So the Lord comes in many different forms, different times, different incarnations, and they all represent different features of the Lord.
主以不同的时间、不同的地点和不同的形象都来到这个世界，他有很多的形象。
But the original Supreme Lord is Bhagavan Sri Krishna.
但是原始的那一位主是 Sri Krishna.
And he possesses all all of the attributes of the Lord, everything in full.
而他的这个形象展示了所有的一切。
But the Lord in the form of Surya Narayan, he will possess some of the things, not everything.
Narayana, 他只展示了一部分主。
Just like in Nectar of Devotion, Rupa Goswami describes 64 different qualities of Lord Krishna.
就像在分外的甘露，是 Rupa Goswami 给我们讲述了主的64项品质。
And he says out of these 64, Lord Narayan or Lord Vishnu, he has 60.
在这64项品质之中，主 Narayana 或主 Vishnu 他有60项。
And Lord Shiva, he's next, he has 55 out of 64.
主 Shiva 有55项品质。
And Lord Brahma, in his most perfect condition, he can have 50 out of 64.
而主 Brahma 在这64项之中只有50项，他是这个创造中最伟大的人物。
So,Lord Krishna has special qualities which are not there in Narayan or Vishnu.
主 Krishna 在那里有他特别的一些品质，是主 Narayana、主 Shiva 或主 Vishnu 没有的。
So he says Lord Krishna is the supreme attractive all personality of Godhead. He's the supreme form of the Lord.
因此主 Krishna 是最具吸引力，他是至尊的这个形象。
When we chant the Gayatri Mantra, the first line of the Gayatri Mantra is the Brahma Gayatri. And in the Gayatri Mantra, Brahma Gayatri, there's a prayer to the, it's mentioned about the sun god.
在这个我们的 Gayatri 曼陀罗中的第一个曼陀罗，第一个曼陀罗崇拜的就是这个太阳神。
So we also pray to the Supreme Lord, but we understand him to be an expansion of the Supreme Lord Krishna.
我们也向他祈祷，但是我们知道他是至尊人格，他是至尊主的一个扩展。
Krishna puts him, he arranges for this Surya Narayan to take the position of the sun god.
Krishna 安排了这个 Surya Narayana 作为太阳神。
He's also God. So we have to offer worship to him.
他也是主。因此我们得向他表示尊敬，就是我们也得崇拜他。Next question from Achintya Beta. Obeisance Maharaj, is sun or jewel polo star center of the universe?
Is the pole star the center of the universe?
He said, is sun or pole star center of the universe? He said two.
Well, we said everything is rotating around the pole star. All the stars and planets, and they're all rotating around the pole star.
我们说所有的一切这些星球都是围绕着这个北极星。
And the sun and the moon, they're also rotating around. They're not just in one place. They also rotate.
太阳、月亮，它不只是在它一个地方待着，它也在围绕着星，它也在运转、旋转。
What's in the center? Who's in the center? I don't know, but Dhruva Maharaj said everything is rotating around it.
到底谁是这个中心？我不太清楚。但是 Dhruva Maharaj 说， 说所有的星球都围绕着它在转。
嗯。Any other
next question? From Tapa Mishra Prabhu, Hare Krishna, Dimbai Guru Maharaj, 请问如何理解主的宇宙形体既是超然的又是短暂的？ Hare Krishna, obeisances to Guru Maharaj, how to understand the Lord's universal form is transcendental but also very temporary?
Yes, it is, because it's the Supreme Lord.It's a form of the Supreme Lord, so it's transcendental, but at the same time it's temporary because it's made up of the material elements. Material elements are all temporary. So it's a temporary manifestation. It's not really anything which a devotee worries about because devotee is not much attracted to the universal form.
是的，它既是超然又是短暂的。是超然的，因为这是主的这个形象，因此它是超然的。是短暂的呢，因为这个形象是物质自然的一种展示，物质自然是短暂的。但是奉献者不太担心这个宇宙形象，因为奉献者不被这个宇宙形象所吸引。
When Arjuna saw the universal form, he was not much impressed. He asked Krishna to show the universal form, but it wasn't for Arjuna's benefit, but it was for the benefit of the non-devotees.
当这个主 Krishna 向 Arjuna 展示宇宙形象的时候， Arjuna 并没有太大的这个受到吸引，因Arjuna要求主 Krishna 展示这个宇宙形象，不是为了 Arjuna 本人的利益，他是为了那些非奉献者的利益才要求主这么做。
Arjuna wanted Krishna to show the universal form to establish his position as the Supreme Lord, to show his position as the Supreme.
Arjuna 希望主 Krishna 展示他的宇宙形体，是为了确立主 Krishna 至尊的这个地位。
It's like a challenge to those people who claim that they're God, that if you're God, then you should show your universal form.
这是一项挑战，对那些自称自己是主，是整个宇宙的主的这种人的一种挑战。如果你认为你是整个宇宙的这个神或者是主的话，请展示你的宇宙形体。
But Srila Prabhupada also describes this universal form as a godless display of opulence.
圣帕帕德也讲述这个宇宙形体是主 Krishna 的一种富裕。
No, godless means
无神论者
display of opulence, yeah. A godless display of opulence, yeah.So for impersonalists and people who are not able to conceive of the divine form of the Lord, then they can take help, they can contemplate the universal form.
对于那些无神论者来讲，他无法看到主的话，他可以去观想主的这个宇宙形体。
But devotees are not much interested in the universal form.Arjuna wasn't interested. He didn't like it.
奉献者不被这个宇宙形体所吸引。Arjuna 也不喜欢这个宇宙形体。Next question.
Yes.
Next question from Harimamsa Prabhu. 这些星球由半世人主宰。可以理解为某个国家由某位总统主宰一样吗？ So these planets are controlled by some demigod. Can we understand some country are also controlled by the president?
Yeah. Well, of course. Yeah, there's people. The point is, you know, there's.People, persons, personalities in charge of different places and different planets, that everything is personal and there are persons in charge, responsible for ruling.
这个事情的要点是所有的这些星球上的控制者是一位人，是人格性的，所有的这一切都是由人格性而控制着的。
So there are governments also. That's a point that, you know, there has to be some organization everywhere, and you have to have a government, and somebody will be the head of the government, the leader of the government. So the same is there in the higher planets, also with the planets and the stars.
有政府就代表这种组织，所有这些星球上都是很有组织的在运行，有组织的运行意味着在这个组织运行背后是有一个控制者。
So we said like the sun is the king of all planets.
我们听到这个太阳是所有星球的国王。
But the sun also is very respectful to the pole star because Dhruva Maharaj is there.
但是太阳星球太阳神他也非常尊敬 Dhruva Loka, 因为 Dhruva Maharaj 在那个地方。
So the main point of often we don't understand that there are personalities there concerned with everything, with the, just like the personality of the earth planet is Bhumi, and she takes the form of a cow.
在这之前我们缺少这种人格的概念，就像这一切都是人格性的，就像这个地球女神她也 Bhumi Devi 地球女神她以一种奶牛的形象化身。
And there's Varuna, the god of the sea. He has a form of water.
Varuna, 这个水神，他以水的形体展现。
And Agni, the god of the fire, he is a fiery form.
Agni Dev, 就是火神，他是有火的这个形体。
So it's difficult for us with our conditioning to understand how all of these different, within all of these different elements there can be persons, but there are.
虽然这有一些困难对于我们去理解这些不同的元素有他们各自的形体和人格性，但是他们确实是存在的。
Because the spirit soul cannot be burned. The spirit soul is not affected by the material conditions.
而这个灵性的灵魂是不会被物质的事情元素所影响的，也不会被燃烧，也不会物质的元素所影响。
So Agni, the god of fire, will have a fiery body, and that fiery body, there's also a soul there within that body.
因此，这个 Agni Dev, 这个火神，这个火。因为这个灵魂是不可以不被火所燃烧，所以在这个火的形体也是有灵魂的。
We're very conditioned. We think you have to have a human body. You have to have this body like our body. Then only you can be a human. Then only you can be a person. No, but there are personalities in every living entity.
我们非常受条件限制。我们认为只有有我们这样的这个形体。才会有这个人类，才会有其他的这个形体，但是不是的，所有的一切形体之中都有这个，都有这种生物存在。
Yeah, any other question?
Next question from Sitarani. Sitarani, 顶拜咕噜，感恩聚会的奉献者。没有成为纯粹奉献者之前，可以通过占星来帮助自己更好地从事奉献服务吗？或者让占星成为传教的工具可以吗？ A basis to Guru, if I when not become a pure devotees, before become a pure devotees, can we use the astrology to help us better engage in devotional service, or can the astrology be a tool in preaching?
Well, astrology is a Vedic science. It's concerned with material world, not with the spiritual world.
占星它是伟达的科学，它还是属于物质的世界，不是属于灵性的世界。
One time, a devotee went to see an astrologer, a very prominent, famous astrologer in the capital of India, in New Delhi. And he went to see this famous astrologer. But when the astrologer saw that he was a devotee, he said, oh, he said, I'm not able to do anything for you. I can't tell you anything because you're a devotee. You're worshipping Krishna. So all the lines on your hand and everything in your stars and chart, they don't have any effect anymore because you're doing devotional service.
一次 奉献者们去到印度的首都新德里去看一个非常有名的这个占星家，当这个占星家知道他们是奉献者的时候，这个占星家说，我不能对你说任何事情，因也不能帮你预测任何的事情，因为你们现在已经是奉献者了，你们已经在主 Krishna 的控制之下了，因而你们成为奉献者，因为成为奉献者之后，你不论是你的手上的这个东西，还是你的星图的这个图表，都不会对你有什么样的影响。
So we should understand.
因为你们在从事奉献服务，所以这些星球、这些图表不会对你有什么影响。
So we don't give a lot of importance to astrology, but if you're really in the material platform, if you're really very, you know, very material, and you're not at all transcendental, then you could look at your chart and you can understand things about yourself.
如果我们并不给太多的这种注意力在这个星盘或者说占星上，如果你实在是处于这种物质的这个状况之中，如果你实在是很想去的话，你可以去看你的这个图表星图星盘。
No, especially things like, you know, when it comes to marriage, because marriage is, you know, it's not really a spiritual thing, it's quite materialistic relationship. And when it comes to arranging a marriage, it's helpful for a man and woman to understand each other better. And you can understand better compatibility and your chances of a good marriage and having children. It can all be seen in the chart.
比如说当婚礼的时候，当两个人要结婚的时候，事实上两个人结婚并不是一种灵性的什么灵性的事情，灵性的这种大部分是属于一种物质的这种关系。两个人在一起结婚，在那个时候，两个人会看一些图，看一些星盘，通过看这个星盘来判断两个人是否合适，是否能够在一起等等这些情况。
嗯 ，So, it's sometimes they do it for the Gurukula boys. They check out the chart of the Gurukula boy. They can understand if the boy is actually suited for the spiritual education and for the type of lifestyle they're going to indoctrinate him into in the Gurukula.
也会有一些 Gurukula 的学校的这些人，他们也会看这个小孩的星盘，他们来看一看这个小孩是否适合在这个古鲁库拉待。
So, I remember when Srila Prabhupada was sick also, sometimes Prabhupada would say, go and see what the astrologers say.
当这个圣帕帕德当时生病的时候，他有时也会问，去看一下那个星盘上是怎么说的。
And the devotees would come back and tell Prabhupada what the astrologer said, and Prabhupada would laugh.
当这个奉献者去问的这个占星家，然后告诉帕帕德这个占星家怎么说的时候，帕帕就开始笑了。
And sometimes the astrologers will say, oh, you have to get this stone, and you put this stone on a ring and wear it on this finger, and, you know, and this will help you to overcome the negative effects which are there in your chart.
有些时候这个占星家也会告诉你，你得带这个石头带在手上，你得带那个宝石带在手上，这将抵消你现在所处的一种不好的运势。
So there's an incident in the Chaitanya Charitamrita where it describes how an astrologer one day came to the home of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
在永恒的柴坦尼亚经里面也描述了有一个占星师他当时来到主柴坦尼亚马哈帕布的家。
So Lord Chaitanya asked him, he said, who was I in my last life?
主柴坦尼亚就问这个占星师，我上一世是谁？
So the astrologer did his calculations and then he looked at Lord Chaitanya and said, in your last life you were the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
这个占星家通过计算然后看着主柴坦尼亚说，你上一世是至尊人格守神。
And Lord Chaitanya said, no I wasn't, I was a cowherd boy.
这个主柴坦尼亚就回答道，不，我不是至尊人格守身，我上一世是一个牧牛童。
So Srila Prabhupada does write there in the purport how astrologers used to give a lot of benefit to society by giving knowledge about, you know, people's character and nature and advising them proper things to do.
圣帕帕德就在这个事情的要旨后面就写到，这占星师他确实给这个社会带来了一些益处，他告诉人们的性格一些知识，给他们一些建议。
He could tell them what was good for their health and what was not good for their health.
这个占星师可以告诉别人你的身体应该吃什么会健康，吃什么会不健康等等。
And I've seen also devotees who had very, you know, it's interesting, sometimes devotees who had very good compatibility, but somehow after their marriage, somehow, although they had a couple of children, somehow the marriage broke up.
有些时候我也很诧异，比如说这个夫妻他们有很好的这个组合，然后呢就是从星盘上看着很好的组合，然后当他们有了孩子之后，突然不知怎么的，他们就离婚了。
Yeah, there was one couple, they had about 90% compatibility, but still the marriage broke up.
比如说一对夫妻，他们有90%的相似，就是融洽度，但是他们最后还是分开了。
So you have to understand, astrology is not absolute.
因此你就得明白了，占星它不是绝对的。
We put our trust in Krishna.
我们把我们的信任给予 Krishna.
But sometimes you can get some indications from astrology. It may be helpful, it may not.
有些时候你可以从占星那里获得一些建议，或许有用，或许没有什么帮助。
All right.
Her second part ask, can we use the astrology to be the tool of the preaching?
Well,It's not really what we want to do for preaching. We want to give people Krishna consciousness. This is not Krishna consciousness.
并不一定能帮助我们，因为我们想给予别人 Krishna 知觉，但是占星而不是 Krishna Krishna 之权。
You're putting the trust into some material science.
你把你的信任放在物质的科学上。
You're not bringing them to Krishna.
你是把别人的信心放在一种物质的科学上，而并没有把别人带到 Krishna 那。
If you want to preach, you want to preach about Krishna. We want to bring people to chant Hare Krishna and to read the Bhagavad Gita. We want them.
如果想传教的话，你应该把人带到 Krishna 那里，让别人去读国家梵科。
We want them to put their trust in Krishna, not in materials and in just stars and planets.
我们应该把别人的信任带到 Krishna 那里去，让别人去信任 Krishna 那里，而不是信任一些星盘、星球。
So I would not recommend this for preaching.
因此我不建议，我不推荐用这个占星去传教。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Devi Shakti Madaji. 顶拜 Guru, 感恩 Prabhu. 有时候我处在 Krishna 之觉中感到满足，但有时候又陷入到 Maya 之中感到恐惧。怎样才能更多的处于 Krishna 之觉之中呢？ Obeisance to Guru Dev. Sometimes I feel I'm in Krishna consciousness and feel satisfied, but sometimes I feel I fall into the Maya and feel. So how to become more in Krishna consciousness?
By engaging more in devotional service, but particularly by hearing and chanting.
通过从事更多的奉献服务，比如尤其是聆听和唱诵。
And it's also very good to engage in the service of devotees.
还有一种比较好的就是从事对奉献者的服务，就是服务奉献者。
If you do service for the devotees, it can be very helpful to get more taste for hearing and chanting.
如果你很好的服务奉献者的话，你会能够得到聆听唱诵的品味。
Sometimes we take things too easily, we become too comfortable in our material life, and it's difficult for us to progress.
有时候我们生活的太容易了，很容易就能生活得很舒适，但是这种舒适并不能帮助我们在灵性之中获得进步。
So don't worry, and Krishna will soon give you more troubles. And the more you have anxiety and trouble, then the more intense you will become engaged in devotional service.
不用担心 ，Krishna 会给你制造一些麻烦的。当你有处在麻烦之中的时候，你会有时间，你会开始思考，你会更处在 Krishna 知觉之中。
Queen Kunti prays for troubles, right? She asks, "Let these calamities come again and again, because they help me to remember Krishna more and more."
主。就是昆体王后的祈祷也是这样的，让灾难一次又一次的降临吧，这样我就能恒常的处在对 Krishna 的记忆之中。
So because you're comfortable, having nice job, nice apartment, very satisfied, everything's comfortable, everything, you don't feel much urgency to become Krishna conscious.
因为你都比较舒适。然后你有很好的工作，你有很好的环境，因此你并没有很好的就是那种紧迫感处在 Krishna 知觉之中。
Maybe you'll get Krishna's mercy, special mercy one day. He'll take everything away from you.
或许有一天你会得到 Krishna 的仁慈， Krishna 把你的一切都拿走。
And then when you're helpless and have nothing, then you might become more serious about Krishna consciousness.
当你什么都没有的时候，很无助的时候，那个时候你就会更有 Krishna 知觉了。
Of course, Krishna doesn't need to take everything away, but if you're very attached to everything, then it might be good for you.
当然 ，Krishna 没有必要把你从一切把你的这一切都拿走，但是如果你很依附这一切东西的话，真的对你不太好。
If these comforts are stopping you from becoming Krishna conscious, then Krishna may take it all away.
如果这些舒适阻止了你想着 Krishna 的话，更有 Krishna 知觉的话， Krishna 可能就会拿走。
So, don't be like that. Don't become so attached to the material that you forget Krishna.
因此，不要太处于物质之中而忘记了 Krishna.
Yeah.
Next question from Gopinath Priya, David Dasi. 顶拜孤儿的莲花族，地球被诸杜尔嘎的能量包裹着，人类被困在这里，如同待在监狱一样。这样，这个理解是对吗？据报道，有些宇航员坐飞船抵达别的星球了，这是怎么回事？受条件限制的灵魂怎么才能离开地球，回到守身的身边？感恩您的解答。First part, the earth is in the control of the Durga Devi, her energy, and people are in this earth plant, like in the prison. Is this understanding right?
Yes.
是对的，这个理解是对的。And the second part, 举报的有些。It reported that some people take the airplane, go to the other plant. Is this things, how to say these things?
You mean the astronauts? The astronauts
yes,
go to
yes.
the moon?
Yes, like this.
Yes, we don't accept, we don't believe really that the astronauts ever went to the moon.
比如说像阿姆斯特丹登上这个月球的事情，这样对于这样的事情，我们是不相信的，我们是不认可的。
According to Vedic science, the sun is nearer than the moon.
就像根据伟达的这个科学，月亮是离我们更远的，太阳是离我们更近的。
So, what did the spaceman actually do? Well.One thing they might have done is they just went into space and they orbited around the Earth planet and then came back. The one thing which the spacemen may have done, they didn't actually go to the moon. They just went up in the air, they went up into the sky and they went around the Earth planet and came back.
有一种可能是这样，他们并没有到达月球，他们只是冲破了这个地球，然后在那个空间上行走了一圈，然后就回来了。
And the film where they show the man is walking and the place where he's walking is just dust. And Prabhupada said that could not be the moon, because the moon is a higher planet, and there's a lot of life, a lot of vegetation there on the moon planet.
第二个就是关于他们去到月球上拍了一个照片，这个照片上有很多的沙，就是像沙漠一样。圣帕帕的说这个是不可能的，因为在月球上，根据我们的圣典伯加瓦坛描述，在月球上应该有很多的植被。
Another possible thing which happened was Prabhupada said maybe they went to Rahu.Maybe they went to the demonic planet.
第三个可能就是圣帕帕德说，或许这些人他们到达的是 Rahu 星球，而不是月球。
Right, we were talking about Rahu. It's a demonic planet. It's not a pious planet. The moon and the sun, they're heavenly planets. They're higher planets. They're planets for pious living entities. But Rahu is a planet for sinful living entities.
我们今天了解到 Rahu 星球是一个隐形的星球，而且它是一个低等的星球，而月球是高等的星球，是天堂星球，到达月球是要有资格的，而去到月球上必须是虔诚的人才可以，去到 Rahu 是一些罪恶的人就可以去到那里。
So they possibly went to Rahu. They landed, if they did land somewhere, then they landed on Rahu.
如果他们确实在什么地方登陆的话，真是很有可能他们是在 Rahu 星球登陆了。So the third part is how the conditional soul can go back, leave this earth planet and go back to the Godhead.
Yes, we leave the earth planet in our spiritual body.We give up the gross body and we go in the spiritual body back to Godhead.
我们离开这个地球是放弃我们的物质躯体，然后带着我们的use our subtle body to go back to Godhead.
Spiritual body.
通过我们带着我们的灵性的躯体回归到我们的回归守神。
Yeah, we give up the gross body and then we give up also the subtle body.
我们先放弃我们的粗糙躯体，然后再放弃我们的精微躯体。
And it's described how the people come from the spiritual world with an airplane and they take you back to Godhead in the spiritual airplane.
在经典中曾描述了，他会从灵性天空中派来这个飞机，然后带着你回到灵性世界。
Right. If you watch, we have a very nice film about Tuka. Tuka, there was a great devotee in India hundreds of years ago, before Lord Chaitanya, there was a person called Tuka, Tukaram.
在这个在印度住柴坦尼亚之前，有这么一个伟大的奉献者叫 Tukaram。
So Tukaram, he was a devotee, a great devotee, and it's described how one day an airplane came, and he got in the airplane and just left, went back to Godhead.
这个伟大的奉献者，这个 Tukaram, 有一天这个灵性的飞机来了，然后带着他回去了。
And we read in the Srimad Bhagavatam about Dhruva Maharaj, how Dhruva Maharaj was in the Bhattarik Ashram in the Himalayas doing austerity, and the aeroplane came to take him back to Godhead.
We in the Srimad Bhagavatam also see Dhruva Maharaj in the Bhattarik Ashram doing austerity, and finally, the aeroplane came.
And he got in the aeroplane, went back to Godhead.And but then he was worried, what about my mother? And he saw there was another airplane taking his mother back to Godhead.
他进入到这个灵性飞机回归守神，然后他就开始担心，那我的母亲怎么办？然后这个旁边的人就说，有另外一架飞机会带着你的母亲回归守神。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Achintya Beta. Beta, obeisance to Maharaj. Is Vastu useful for Sadaka? Thank you very much.
Sadaka.
Sadaka, Bhakta.
Sadhana. Is it? Sadaka.
Sadaka.
I don't know what Sadaka is. What does she mean, Sadaka?
Maybe the new devotee, the nearby devotee.
Ask her, what does she mean?
Sati Mataji, 您问问这个 Achintya Beta Beta, 问一下这个 Sadaka 是什么意思。Next question. 顶拜古鲁的莲花族一 Narayana 是 Mahavishnu 二请问 Gurudev 二 Juna 是在薄伽梵歌是在薄伽梵歌 2.7 乘伏还是在薄伽梵歌 18.66 乘伏 First he asked Narayana is the Mahavishnu
I don't know about that. Mahavishnu is one of the Purusha avatars.
Mahavishnu is a Purusha avatar.
Narayan, Lord Narayan, resides in the spiritual world. Mahavishnu, he's in the causal ocean.
Mahavishnu 在元因之洋。
I don't know. I don't know. It's difficult. I wouldn't say that Lord Narayan is exactly the same as Mahavishnu.
很难确定的说 ，Narayana 就是 Mahavishnu。So second, he asked, I want to ask a Guru, is Arjuna surrendered to Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita chapter 2 or he surrendered in the chapter 18?
Well, he surrendered in chapter 2. He said, now I am your disciple and a soul surrendered unto you. Please instruct me. So he was surrendering to Krishna to get instruction. In chapter 2. Then in chapter 18, he surrenders to Krishna's instruction.
Lord in chapter 18 to surrender his instruction.
Yes, Tagui Tada Tsunshi.
然后 Arjuna 在十八章的时候就开始皈依他的训示。
Yeah. Krishna tells Arjuna in the 18th chapter, he said, now you decide, Arjuna, what are you going to do?
也就是说在第二章的时候就是臣服他准备做他的门徒在第十八章的时候是臣服他的训示所以这个 Krishna 也问 Arjuna 你现在准备好了吗你准备怎么做
So then Arjuna said yes I'm ready to act according to your instruction I'm ready to I've heard from you now I'm ready to act
所以 Arjuna 就回答是的我准备好了我准备作战我从你那里聆听，现在我准备作战，准备臣服你的这个训示。
嗯、mm-hmm. ，OK。
Yes, next question from Jai Govinda Mataji.
Yeah, yes, Sadaka.
Okay. Yes, Sadaka is new devotees.
A new devotee.
Yeah.
So what's the question? Woman, the one
is the vastu useful for the new devotees?
Vastu is useful if you're building a house or building a temple.
Vastu 是对这个有用的地方在于建庙和建盖你的家的时候是有用的。
Vastu will help you to design where your entrance should be, where your door should be, where the kitchen should be, where the toilet should be.
Vastu 会告诉你你的进门在什么地方你的卧室在什么地方你的厨房在什么地方你的这个马桶在什么地方
So Vastu can help us in these kind of things so to avoid any difficulties
Vastu 就是能够帮助我们避免一些困难
We had one. I was at one temple in Malaysia. I remember, and we used to regularly have accidents right in front of our temple.
我记得在这个马来西亚，在我们庙的这个前面，总是会有一些事故发生，庙的正前面。
Many times, not one time.
不是一次，而且有很多次。
So one devotee came and he knew Vastu and he said, you know, if you lock this door and open the other door, there were two doors, you know, and just a little distance apart. He said, if you close this door and open the other door, he said, that will stop this problem. And as soon as we did that, there were no more accidents.
当这个有一个奉献者来到那儿，他懂这个 Vastu， 他就说，如果你把这个门关掉，因为这个庙有两个门，你把现在这个门关掉，把另外一个门打开，这个事情就会截止。当他们真的这么做的时候，确实就没有再发生这个事情了。
So Vastu, it can, you know, by how you design your house, it can make it can change the atmosphere. You may have the house designed one way, and they may constantly have arguments and quarreling going on in the house. But if you change the Vastu, then sometimes it can stop everything. The home will become just more peaceful and quiet.
This Vastu 有时候能够帮助我们改变家里的气氛。比如说，有时候这个房子如果这样建，或者说这样怎么一个情况的话，家里总是有不好的气氛，会有两个人会有争吵。但是你改变这个Vastu的话，可能会改变这个家里的气氛。
So again, it's a material science.
这还是物质的科学。
To improve, to try to create more auspicious environment, auspicious atmosphere.
这是为了创造一种更好的气氛，更好的环境。Next question from the Jaya Govinda Mataji, David Dasi, 顶拜 Guru 和翻译。您刚才说宇宙一共有14个星球，星宿，请问地球在中间的第几层 ？Obeisance to Guru Maharaj, you just said there are totally 14 levels. So, the earth is in which level?
7.
地球是在第七个，第七层。
From the top, 7 down.
从顶上到下，从顶上往下数第七个。
We're in the middle.
Yes. Next question from Shyamakri.Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Dev 和所有的奉献者，灵性世界的飞机接奉献者都是回外昆塔。我想知道回 Goloka Vrindavan 是怎样回去的。Hare Krishna, faces to Guru Dev. The spiritual airplane take the devotees go back to the Vaikuntha. I want to know how the devotees go back to the Goloka Vrindavan.
Shavasati.
Well, we'll have to wait and find out, right? The devotee, how do the devotees go back to Goloka?
Yes.
Do they have an airplane to take it to Goloka? Well, you know, Gop Kumar, in this Brihad Bhagavat Amrita, we read about Gop Kumar, and he would go everywhere by mantra.
We listen to this Da Bo Jia Wa Tan Gandung Zhi Yang, we listen to Gopa Kumar, he went to any place, just through a mantra.
By mantra, he didn't need airplanes, and just by mantra meditation, he was able to transport himself, and he went to all these places. So, if our mind is fixed on Krishna, Krishna says, I am the swift deliverer from the ocean of birth and death.So if we are ready to go back to Godhead, Krishna will come and he will take us there.
我们不用担心我们是怎么样 当我们真的有信心对 Krishna 的时候， Krishna 说我是把你从这个枝阳，从这个物质之阳提起来的。这一位，当我们不用担心 Krishna 会把我们带走。
Krishna will come, maybe he will come on the back of Garuda and take us there.
或许 Krishna 会坐在 Garuda 的背上带走我们回去。
Maybe we will just go there, just we'll go there in our spiritual body. We can just come there.
或许我们只是回到那儿，只是通过我们的灵性躯体就可以回到那里。
Jiva Goswami says, before we go back to Godhead, we have to go and take birth first of all in Krishna's, where Krishna is appearing in the material world.
Shin Jiva Goswami 描述到，当我们要回归灵性世界之前，回归守神之前，我们会去到 Krishna 在物质世界上演逍遥时光的那个地方也显现。
And we take part in Krishna's pastimes and we get more.Preparation for going back to Godhead.
我们参与 Krishna 的逍遥时光之中，然后做更多的准备回归守身。
So at that time, other personalities will also be there with Lord Krishna. They come from the spiritual world, Nitya Siddha devotees.
那个时候也会有其他的奉献者来参与这个 Krishna 的逍遥时光。他们是 Nitya Siddha 永恒解脱的灵魂，他们是从灵性世界来的。
And so after Krishna's pastimes are finished, they will also go back to the spiritual world. They'll go back to Goloka. So we can go with them. Don't worry, Krishna will make arrangements if we are qualified.
担心 Krishna 会做好一切的安排，只要我们有资格。
But it's a good question. I appreciate your thinking.
但这是一个好问题，我非常欣赏你在思考这一点。
Any more questions? 还有问题吗？
没有。
没有问题了，公爹。
Okay.Okay, so we'll stop here. Mama Jintian Daojer, Ganshiya Fungshenze Ling Ting, Ganshiya Soyada Fungshenze Tiwanti Ling Ting, Ganshiya Tsuburi Rai Giwaman Jintai Dufani, Ganshiya Sati Jujer, Jufu Nimani Kadisi Kwaila, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Oh, 我们又有一个问题提上来。
Okay.什么问题？
那好的，也是一位顶拜咕噜的莲花族，请问生物永恒本性是服务，永恒伴随是离开躯体也存在吗？本性是服务，永恒伴随是离开躯体也存在，不太理解这个提问的问题是什么意思。
如果你不知道，我肯定也不知道。
是，我在
跟
对
方
竞争。
是。谁提问？谁的
问题？好像是一位新人，不知道没有名字。
Okay, 所以我们
那这样吧，我们把这个问题留到。
呀，
你。
你可以，
我把这个问题留下来，一会儿让他打清楚了，然后
你可以问他，
周二再回答吧。好的。
Okay, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.